you look at it over a period of 10 or so years in Hollywood, so not music but filmed entertainment, and you try to understand who has made the most money, not who's got the most Academy Awards or had the biggest box office winner, but who's made the most money, what you saw, at least in the period of time that I looked at, was the answer was Fox, 21st Century Fox. I don't know that that's still the answer, but it was when I looked at it. And what Fox had done is they had been very disciplined about understanding the movie-going audience. And so they had basically taken the US population and after that the international population, and they'd looked at what are the audience segments, pretty broad. So they concluded that teenage girls was one pretty prolific movie-going segment. And they quantified the number of moviegoers and the number of home video consumers and the different windows. And they said, okay, that the number of people is X and their propensity to spend is Y. Therefore, the opportunity for a great film is Z, right? And so they sort of quantified that. And then they said, okay, given that, here's how much we can afford to, here's how many movies we make per year to hit that audience, and here's how much we can afford to spend. And this is unheard of in Hollywood, right? And so rather than go to, you know, Brad Pitt and say, Brad, what have you got going? And could we make that film? They said, we're going to buy a script that meets these needs, and we're going to put talent in, both, you know, director and actors, that do not go above a certain threshold, and then we're going to market it in the following way, not over a certain threshold. And they made a lot of money doing it. So you may remember the film Devil Wears Prada. And then the following year it was 27 Dresses, and the following year it was something after that. And so they were very disciplined about it.